Hi everyone, my name is So San Hua, dietitian certified diabetes educator, as well as TOS director of training. And today I want to share with you how to fit it all in when you have a super busy schedule. So as you all know, I have a very busy schedule. I work for the corporate as a TOS director of training. I personally have in my private practice. So I run my own group. I have my one-on-one clients. And on top of that, I am a mom of two young daughters, which is 4 and 6 years old. So you can understand how busy my schedule. So let me give you a look at my busy schedule. This is my daughter Zoom training every single day. So how do I fit it all in? So this is how I want to fit it all in. And a lot of people said, because I do want to eat healthy, I do want to maintain a healthy lifestyle, but I am just so busy. And I totally get it. Me too. I would like to say I'm too busy to take care of my health, but unfortunately, and I cannot say that, is because when I don't take care of my health, my family suffer because I don't have energy. And the most important thing, I'm not in a good mood. I don't think many kids will like their mom not in a good mood. So I understand by taking care of myself, I'm actually doing a great job as a mom to take care of my kids. And I want to be a positive role model for my daughter. So first of all, I often say schedule the things that are non-negotiable. So when I, every day, especially on Sunday. Sunday is a very special time for me. Every time on Sunday, I do, this is what I do. And this is something for me to suggest for you to consider. Every Sunday is my prep day. Prep day in so many ways, prep day, not just prepping my food, because prepping is so important so that it prevents you from falling into a trap of eating convenience food, which is often not too healthy. So number one, I usually do all my prepping on a Sunday. Second is I do all my planning in my schedule also on Sunday. Something like this that I created, so my husband and I know exactly what the kids' schedule is all done on Sunday, because the teacher often send out the schedule on the weekend and I put them together because I have two children and they have different timing. And on top of my meeting and my one-on-one, you can see it's like fitting a puzzle to make sure everything fits. And it is challenging, no doubt for sure. I always say every challenge, you will always learn something new. We always have to think positive. So in my schedule, I usually put in, I have a phone, which I use as a calendar, but I usually have a book where I write down everything, my calendar book, and I put in the time right there. So this is as a reference, and I wrote in the time, and I always say what gets scheduled gets done. What doesn't get scheduled never gets done. So when I schedule, things that I schedule first is things that are non-negotiable. So my morning routine is non-negotiable. If I have time, I stretch my time, I stretch my routine a little bit longer. If I don't have time, I just make my routine shorter, but I still go through the motion doing exactly the same thing. So my morning routine always involved with writing three things that I'm grateful for, because I need to start and I want to start my day positively with the right mindset. And I might even end with a positive affirmation and say, "So San, today is a great day and you can do hard things." That would be, and maybe give myself a high five in the mirror. So that's number one I will do. Number two that I will do is I do some form of movement. So the movement could be yoga, it could be some short, high intensity workout. Like I said before, I have a very busy schedule. Sometimes my workout could be only a 15 minutes, it could be a 10 minutes, whatever I choose, but I choose to at least do some form of movement. So that I must include. Number three, I need to replenish my water. So I always do my water in the morning and I do my isotonic in the morning, because I need to nourish my body. So these are the three basic things that I do every single morning regardless. And I do lemon water too. For those of you who continue with the lemon water, I continue with the lemon water because I love the lemon water so much. So these are the very basic that I include before I start my day. And as I said before, if I have more time, I stretch that routine longer to say half an hour to 45 minutes. If I don't have time, I can squeeze it to 15 minutes, but I make sure I have it every day to start my day. And this is how I plan it. Because again, as I said before, what gets scheduled gets done. Then this next thing, so I schedule my me time, then I schedule my kids time, because I said it's non-negotiable. After I schedule my kids time, guess what I schedule? I schedule my work time, then the rest I fill up with everything else. So I find that helped me really stay grounded on what's most important, because in the end is I do have a long to-do list. Trust me, I have a long to-do list. And I often ask myself, what are the most three important things that I must get done that day? Most important three things. Okay. You know, there was a quadrant that I used to do all the time was, you know, most important, most urgent, or most important, not urgent, or not urgent, not important, or important, not urgent, right? There's this kind of combination. And I find that sometimes when you do that, it gets very complicated. And when I have time, I do that. Trust me, I still do that. However, I always ask myself every single day after I place my schedule, I wrote down three most important things that I must get done that day. If I have more time to do the rest, it's a bonus. But if not, if I can complete those three things, I pat myself on the back and say, Sosan, you did a great thing, and my day is done. And I find that helped me a lot to help me stay grounded, but at the same time to prioritize what's important to me, which is to take care of my kids, to have my morning routine. But like I said before, my Sunday is so important because my prep work. So I do all my vegetable prepping. I even prepare all my meats. I might even roast all my meat. So all I have to do for lunch is just assembly work. And I find that works so well together. So I hope these tips help you for those mom and those dad who have a super busy schedule, how to fit it all in. Thank you very much. I'll see you next time. Bye, everyone.